Good evening, I'm Asad Ahmed. Army veterans gathered in London today calling for the better treatment of service personnel. One ex-military Londoner who survived a bomb attack says it's unfair that some Irish Republican extremists have avoided prosecution while members of the armed forces are being pursued. Here's Sarah Harris.
It was more than three decades ago that Londoner Steve Sullivan survived the blast of an IRA bomb in Hyde Park. Today, he's standing shoulder to shoulder with other veterans to ask for the alleged bomber to be brought to justice. Four soldiers and seven horses were killed by a nail bomb as they made their way to the changing of the guard ceremony in 1982. Steve and his horse led the way.
I'd never seen anything like it in my life. There was blood everywhere. And the fire is one thing that sticks in my mind. I didn't know what to do, so I just got down on one knee and I started stroking a horse's head.
Families and veterans gathered in Whitehall believe members of the armed forces are being unfairly prosecuted for killings during the Troubles, where some Republicans remain unpunished.
Despite the perception of bias from people here, police figures show that, in fact, the vast majority of legacy cases they're looking into were concerning Republicans.
Some people would say the best memorial is the peace process, and isn't it time just to let it go?
Yeah, that would be great. I mean, if you drew a line in the sand, so to speak, and said, look, you know, it's all water under the bridge, we will forgive and forget. It's as simple as that. There's children there that haven't got dads now, and haven't got mums. You know, they need some form of justice.
Proud of their years of service, many don't want to see anyone jailed, but want some kind of justice for the friends they lost and protection for those they argue were just doing their jobs. Sarah Harris, BBC London News.
Thank you. laying wreaths, aren't they?
Yeah.
Streets.